Hi, and welcome to this Phantasm tutorial. I'm Sebastian Bleek, and in this episode, I'll be taking you through how to apply a Phantasm filter. Overall, we'll cover targeting your objects and applying your Phantasm filters. So now that you've decided you want to apply a Phantasm filter, the first thing you need to do is target your artwork. Over on the left in the Tools panel, notice I have the Selection tool activated. You can click on it once or just hit the V key on your keyboard and that'll activate it as well. I'm going to click once on my artwork and now I have this entire group targeted. You can confirm that by taking a look in the Appearance panel or in the upper left section of your screen. Now that I have this group targeted, it's time to apply a Phantasm filter. Up at the top under Object, scroll down until you find Filters, and in there you're going to find Phantasm. Along with that, you're going to see all these different filters you could apply. I'm going to go with a quick levels adjustment. In here, I'm going to grab the midtones, click and drag towards the right, and once I release, notice we've made an adjustment to not only the red mesh, but the stem and the leaf. So we're making an adjustment to the entire group. I'm going to click OK, and that's going to apply that permanent change. Now let's take a look at that one more time, but this time I'd like to just make an adjustment to the red mesh itself. Again, I have the selection tool activated. I'm going to double click on my artwork. That's going to bring us into this isolation mode. All right, when I click on this red mesh, notice I'm only targeting this red mesh. Again, you can confirm that by taking a look in the Appearance panel or in the upper left section of your screen. Now let's apply a filter to this mesh. I'll go to the top under Object, Filters, Phantasm. This time, I'm going to go with the Brightness and Contrast adjustment. All right, when I increase the brightness, check this out, I'm only making an adjustment to the red mesh. Again, I'm going to make a change to the contrast, and I'm only making an adjustment to this red mesh. The stem and the leaf are left as they were originally. I'm going to click OK. Now, to get out of this isolation mode, it's really easy. All you have to do is double click on your artboard, and now you're out of isolation mode. When you click on your artwork, you're targeting the entire group again. And that's it for this tutorial. Overall, we've covered targeting your objects and applying your Phantasm filters. Do watch the next episode in order to understand how to apply specific adjustments. Don't forget, all of our plugins are available for free trial at astutegraphics.com. Thanks for watching.